Welcome to another hands-on lesson. In this lesson, we're going to use the Amazon ECS service to create an AWS Fargate cluster. So back in the EC2 management console, I'm going to search for the Elastic Container Service ECS. In the ECS console here, we have an option to use the new experience. They've been trying to change this for quite some time now, well over a year. I think it's definitely time to use the new console, which is pretty well functional. The old one still has a couple of things that you can't do in the new console. But for Fargate, we should be just fine. So I'm going to choose clusters and then create cluster. So what we want to do here is just give it a name. I'll call it my Fargate cluster and then choose the networking configuration. Now, by default, it's just chosen a VPC, which is the default VPC and all of the subnets in that default VPC. So I'm happy with that. I will leave it as it is. For infrastructure, by default, it has enabled Fargate, and you can see that's actually grayed out, and it tells us that it's serverless, which is great. You could choose EC2 as well, and then you would be able to run the EC2 launch type, which is where you manage your own instances. Now, we're not going to do that. We'll use Fargate, so we'll keep things nice and serverless. And that's all you need to do there. We simply create the cluster. Now you may get this error message, and this is kind of normal. This is happening when you run the cluster creation for the first time. Now what happens is in the back end, AWS is creating a service link role. For some reason, this just happens. So let's do it again. Just put in the same details. So I'm going to call it my Fargate cluster. Of course, we left all of the settings as defaults, and let's try and create the cluster again. And there we go. This time it worked perfectly. So now we have our cluster that's ready to use. Let's choose the cluster. And here we have a few options. So remember, a service is the way that we can configure the number of running tasks we want. So we can define the number of tasks that should be running at all times. Or we can simply go to tasks and just run a new task. Now we will need something called a task definition before we can run any tasks. So let's go back up to the top of the console here, choose task definitions. We're going to create a new task definition. I'm going to call this my Nginx. For name, we're going to type Nginx, and the same for the image URI. And we'll leave the default settings. It's going to run on port 80. Choose next. We keep it on Fargate, which is fine. And we'll leave the default settings for the amount of vCPU and memory that the task will need. I will just scroll down to the very bottom of the page, click on next, and then create. That's it. We now have our task definition. Let's go back to clusters, choose our cluster, go to tasks, and then run new task. So what we need to do here, we can leave Fargate as the capacity provider, scroll down to where we see task definition. We're going to specify my Nginx. Just going to have one task for now. And then under networking, we're going to leave the default VPC specified and all of these six subnets. Now it's going to use the default security group in the VPC by default. So we'll need to go and add a rule to allow port 80 using that security group. So let's deploy our task. While that's happening, I'm going to go to the VPC management console just to edit that security group. So let's go to security groups. I need to find the default security group in the VPC. I know it's this one here. Go to inbound rules, and I'm going to edit and then add a rule for HTTP. And that will be from anywhere. Save that rule. Now we have the security group set up. So let's come back in and see how our task is doing. Well, it looks like it's running. That's great. So what I'm going to do is click on the task ID in the left here, and we should find that we have a public IP address. And if we open a new browser window and paste that in, we have the welcome to Nginx page. So that task is running. Really, really simple. And they start very, very quickly as well. So let's go back up to tasks. And what I'm going to do is simply stop this task. And that's going to go away very quickly. So the other thing we can do, and let me just get rid of these so we can see the screen a bit better, is create a service. So let's just see how to create a service. So again, we're going to use the Fargate capacity provider, select our Nginx cluster. We need to give it a service name, so I'll just call it my service. And let's say I want to have two tasks running. For networking, again, we're just going to leave all the default settings. And here we could optionally add a load balancer if we had one. And that could be an application or a network load balancer. So that's all I want to define. Let's click on deploy. You can now see that my service has been created and zero of two tasks are running. So hopefully it won't take too long before we have our two tasks. And we should be able to see them here. So we can see the stop task, which was the first one we ran, and then we've got these two tasks, which are now starting up. So we can see these are now both in the running status, and in services, it tells us that we have two of two tasks running. So that's it. That's how simple it is to run ECS containers using the serverless Fargate service. So I'm finished with these. I'm simply going to delete my service, and we can choose force to make sure that it does terminate our tasks. And that should clean up quite quickly. Now the cluster itself doesn't cost you anything, so you can just leave it there if you like, and then use it whenever you need to.